I'm wanting to talk about designing your painting. I'm Michelle Manriquez from Drop That Brush, where we help non-artists become artists. Please like, subscribe, and hit the bell. When we make paintings, we are offering a communication between you and the person who's looking at the artist. We are entertainers, whether we're no different than actors, poets. We tell a visual story. So it's really important that we keep our visual story interesting. And one of the main ways that we can do that is to simply have good shapes. Most of this information came from Tony Couch's Key for Successful Paintings. And so mine's the 1972 version, but there's a newer version, I think in 1995. This information has been out there for a long time, but people don't talk about it much. What's the difference between blah art versus wow art? Sometimes it's the feeling, and everybody can feel it. Many times it's shapes, sometimes it's values. So there's certain things that come into art that make it more exciting. We are not able to make a cat on a two-dimensional surface, but I can make shapes. The most basic thing is line. And I'm gonna give you some examples of how I've used that. First is horizontal, which is a very stable, calm. So if you're wanting to have a picture that is very calm and gentle, you keep in the horizontal line. Vertical is proud. Vertical can be things like boats, people, where everything, there's many lines going up. Curve lines can be, there'd be a small amount of movement. So it could be things like gentle waving rolls go in the ocean, but it's a little movement. Then we come into oblique lines. Oblique lines are basically tell you movement. Depending upon how the movement moves, if it's straight down, that's a lot of movement. If it's just a little bit of movement, it just gives you some movement in the picture. And that can make it more exciting than just being a very flat, calm picture. Depends on what you're looking for. What are you designing for? Now, one thing about oblique movements, you don't want to send the people out of the picture. So at the each end, you want to calm it down. So if your movement is going up and then at the edge, calm it and make it flat. Because here's what happens. Otherwise, your picture goes whoop and just goes off. I know that sounds weird, but it really, your eye just goes off. So let's talk about shapes. The most boring shapes are the circle, triangle, where everyone's the same size, and the square. Try to avoid those. Sometimes it does happen, but then I have a fix. So how many things are circles? Well, some people, trees can be very circular. Houses, if you paint it on straight on, could be very much square. So the problem with boring shapes is you're no longer entertaining. There is no variation. So you want to look at shapes in your painting. What are okay shapes? They're not bad shapes, but your first would be an oval, not bad. An oval can be, when you're taking a picture for a flower, it's much better to position your flower in an oval. It's much more interesting. How about rectangle? Rectangle's okay, but they're not really great shapes. Triangles are different. You want to make sure that everything is a different size. It's called a scalene triangle. I looked it up. So I'm not really sure, but basically that every edge is different. Those are okay shapes. What are good shapes? Good shapes are anything that has an oblique angle. So we're talking about oblique has movement. Anything that has movement is more interesting than a very static shape. Oblique movements could be where the shape is smaller than the other end. So one area could be smaller and it moves into a bleak shape, which means some kind of movement, and at the end is normally larger. Good shapes have movement. They are normally longer than wide. And to make it really interesting, you have to have overlapping. Let's talk about overlapping. Children, when they first do drawing, they will take a house, and then over here there will be a tree, and the mountains are over here. Nothing is attached. And when we have a picture, sometimes nothing is attached. You're looking at the picture and so you're here, you are, you're trying to take the picture. You're gonna do the picture, man. The picture says it's this and this and this. But if it's a bad picture, it's really important that you start attaching things. So how to have the best kind of pictures where you have interesting shapes? They have to have oblique angles and they have to have puzzle pieces. So if I have a shape, if it is a oval, then there should be leaves or something that goes into that so that there is an overlapping from one shape to another and it tucks into that shape. It could be a shadow of a tree going into the roof side. It could be a tree laying onto the roof. Again, all of a sudden now it becomes a much more interesting picture. The first thing I do, I spend a lot more time actually thinking about the picture than I do the painting. The painting's pretty fast, but the actual thinking and trying to determine and how to design it makes such a difference. Let's talk about the first thing we do, the outline of the paper. It's really important. And I thought, well, who cares? You know, I can just do whatever I want. No, you really need that outline. So is it a square outline? And if I take that square and do a cross in the middle, that's the most boring shape ever. There's a reason why most paintings are either a rectangle. It's because that's the most best shape we can get with the outside edges. So, but if I go right in the middle, it is very boring. That's why when we are doing our focal point, you always want to shove it over to the side. You never want to be in the middle. And you'll hear people say that, but this is why, is because it's boring. So to make it interesting, you always shove your person, your focal point, and whether it's going this way or that way, it needs to make it exciting. So you can see this is a much more, the final picture is a much more exciting picture where everything is a different size. And that's kind of what you're looking for. So that's the first thing I look for, is where am I gonna make this exciting? To break up the picture. That's the first thing I even do anything. It's just, how do I break it up properly? This is afternoon nap. Now, he basically is a very flat surface. I purposely made him where he, because he's my focus, I wanted him to be the upper part. Then because it was flat, right? That static, it's not very interesting. I purposely made the movement from the tree down to the tree trunk more interesting. It would have some movement. Otherwise, if I do it here and here across, it's okay, but it's not very interesting. So that was my goal. I tried to make sure that the tree up on top was bigger than the bottom, which is the trunk. I actually thought about this and tried to make it an interesting shape. All right, here's another one. Again, it's straight, proud. This is my first thing. So I don't put the little girl in the middle. I shove it to the side. Then because she is straight and kind of static, then I moved a line that moved from one side around it, around, and moved it so there was some movement. For this one, I moved the shape over left. I moved the shape over. But again, she is straight down, but the movement of her arm was actually beautiful and it was graceful. And there was movement in the picture to begin with. I love this. I wanted to show movement. So my first thing was how to break up the picture to show movement. So instead of making him straight, I tipped him a little bit. And then I also tipped the second movement. Two things. The first picture when I'm looking at it, it's gonna be how do I break that first original rectangle? And do I need movement? Do I want calm? What's your intentions of to show this picture? You are the artist. You get to determine what the picture will say to your viewers. As I started looking at this, I thought of some ideas that I should have done. But you know, it's always a process to design. It's never going to be, oh, it's perfect. Oh yeah, you can always find something you could have done a little better or different. But I want you to know why I was attracted to this particular painting. It was this shape. If you look at this shape between her hand, her beautiful movements, and to the other hand, it was a beautiful shape. That was what it turned me on. And that's what I want you to start looking for, is looking for things that are, you know, whether it's value, is that what turns you on? You need to know why you like that. It could be value, it could be a shape, it could be the gracefulness of her movement. Here's what I noticed as I'm looking. I should have attached scarf to her hair. And I'm not sure why I didn't, but I'm looking at it and that would have made it more harmonious between the her shape. So what are positive shapes? The cat is a positive shape. The negative shapes are the white shapes. And some shapes are better than others, right? Number one is kind of boring. Number four is also very boring. But look what I did on number two and number three. You'll see that there's ins and outs. There is puzzle pieces that allows you to make it fun and interesting. I also want you to note each shape is very different from one shape to the other. And that's something you need to think about as you're doing your designing your painting. What you want to do is, as you shove things over, how can you make things interesting? How can you entertain people? How do you take a sleeping cat and make them fun, right? Because really, a sleeping cat, not that exciting. I look at not only the positive shapes, but I also look at the negative shapes and to see how that'll be interesting. If I'm looking at the shape of the cat, number two and number three are more important shapes, and number four and number one aren't as important. I want you to know what got me excited about this. You see that big shape that I outlined? I painted that in one fell swoop. It is a beautiful shape. And I immediately saw it because I understand and look at shapes. And I went, oh, it's so perfect. It's so cool. Ins and outs. I want you to look at the puzzle piece that it made without even trying. It was just amazing picture. I used 3 colors. They were shocked when they watched me paint it. It was one big shape. But I also want you to look at the negative spaces around it. Number one is your papa shape. He is the biggest negative shape. And he's very interesting. He is the important guy. He moves and wiggles. Now let's talk about number 2 and number 3. Let's talk about the shape. Number 2 is not that boring. It's kind of boring, but the line work is very oblique and it's kind of falling off of the edge. I caught that later on, but you know, you learn. But it definitely has movement. But that's a good example of it could just fall off the edge. However, it goes down, moves, and then it kind of levels off at the edge. So that was why I was trying to do that. The other one, number 3, is a nice triangular shape, but it goes straight up the edge. So there was some issues, but what turned me on was a very, very dark that just rolled throughout of the painting. This is an interesting painting. These pumpkins I got out in the grocery store and I started taking pictures and I'm posing my pumpkins, you know? I'm sure they thought I was really weird because I wanted it to be a good composition because frankly, pumpkins, not so exciting. How I designed the pump. The original line is a line that separates the top to the bottom and it's not in the middle. So I did good with that. The second thing is I wanted to make sure that there was overlap. And if you can see, the bigger shape is in front of the middle shape and the baby shape is in front of the middle shape. So there's overlapping. I want you to see where I purposely designed that shape would move through the picture. I painted that in one fell swoop. So really look at it. It's not like I said, okay, here's my shadow, stop. Here's the other shadow, stop. It's one big shape and I actually painted it recognizing that that is a shape and it was a good shape. It goes in and out. Then we look at what kind of line work do we have and it mainly is curved lines throughout. I purposely arranged the shadows so that there would be movement, a still life. You can really take your time to make sure the pictures are fun and you can see my negative shapes are very weird. The one in the middle, that's my best shape because it goes in and out and you can see that there's movement underneath. I also want you to note a little thing that was cool. I want you to look at the tiny pumpkin and I actually made sure the shadow sends you back to the original stems, which then sends you back through, and we're looping around, which allows you to make it an interesting, fun shape. Flowers are circles. So we have to be careful when we're photographing or to make things different. So this is an example of, I am looking for things that I can do overlapping that will allow the shape to be not be a circle. So on this hollyhock picture, hollyhocks are notorious for what? They are notorious for being circles. And I swear, you try to change it, it's hard to get. You have to really work for it. So, and rather than fighting it, I made sure that there were 2 shapes that now could be one shape, which made it more interesting. Dominant direction of line is vertical with a little obliqueness. So there'd be a little movement. What could I have done to make this better? Well, I'm going to tell you why. again, I had a chance to look at it. I should have probably made, because these had movement, I should have had some kind of a stable movement in the lower third of the picture where the main flowers are. There could have been a darker area that should have changed it. And I think that would have made a better picture. It's okay, I'm learning. But I was recognizing that the shapes were not good, and to make sure that as I'm looking at my pictures, what would have a good shape? What else do I have? I have overlapping, because there's flowers behind it and there's overlapping that makes the shapes more interesting. You have mama, papa, baby in that shape. So I have the big one, the mama, and the second one is the little baby. And that's something that's something to think about as you're doing this. Shapes should be interesting. You are an entertainer and you want to make it fun, entertaining. And the way you do that, the first thing to look at is lines, directions, and shapes. And are they good shapes or not? And can you switch it up to make it a good shape? So you hear, you've got your picture and you're looking at it. Number one, what turns you on about it? Was it light, dark? Was it the graceful movement of the shape? Look and say, okay, it's up and down, so I'm gonna make sure that there's some movement. The edges, it's gonna be portrait or horizontal. Do you wanna move something over? The actual focal shape is right in the middle. You need to purposely shove it over. Is it interesting or is it boring? If it's boring, fix it, change it. You do not have to paint the picture exactly how it looks. I promise. Nobody's going to yell at you if you change a little bit. What direction would be best for this picture? Vertical, horizontal. Once you determine, are you going to mainly do oblique lines? If they're mainly oblique, try to encourage more oblique lines. If you want to do horizontal lines, how can you make it more exciting? Using an oblique line here and there, but mainly make it soft. If you want to keep it all very kind of calm, it depends upon what you're looking for. Is your line going to be curvy, straight, horizontal, oblique? Look at your sizes. Can you change the sizes? If you've got three rocks that are all the same size, break it up. Make a mama, papa, and baby. Make it different. Don't just say, oh, well, they're all three the same rock, so I must paint that. Don't do that. As you set up your lines, check out the negative shapes. Are they interesting? Are they boring? To make sure that they are locking like a puzzle piece. But try to make sure as much as you can make it interesting. So when you have a shape, you're gonna want, even if two edges are boring, try to make the third much more interesting. You are in charge of your painting. You do not have to do exactly what you're looking at. I had a student and she did a nice picture. And it was, she did exactly what the picture said, a geese that was yodeling up. And I had no idea what it was because she did exactly what the picture. I said, what is this? I mean, I could see it was some kind of a bird thing, but there's something wrong with a beak, man. It was messed up. I'm like, what's going on with his face? She says he was yodeling. He was making noise. And I'm like, okay, but if the picture doesn't make sense, it won't make sense to the viewer. So your picture should communicate your idea, your feeling to come through in your paintings. When you don't know what you're doing and you're just playing, thinking about it, drop that brush. Like, subscribe, and ring that bell. You know what? Next week, we're going to talk about value and color. Now, All of you were thinking, all right, cool, we're gonna go mix. No, we're not gonna mix. We're talking about design and color and value and how we try to make it more exciting. Again, our goal is to communicate people what we're feeling. You have a great day and take care. Bye.